In today's video, we are going to scrape businesses from Yelp for free. Yelp is a large database listing small and medium-sized companies in a specific location. We can extract up to 240 companies per search, including websites and phone numbers. If you want to get more leads and to retrieve email addresses, among other things, you can visit scrape.io. Scrape.io allows you to scrape Google Maps at scale. By clicking the link in the description and creating your account, you can get your first 100 leads free of charge. Now, let's come back to the tutorial. As an example, I'm going to extract restaurants in Seattle, and I'm going to do it thanks to Octoparse, which is a freemium web scraping tool. I also let you this link in the description. As usual, there are two different ways to scrape things with Octoparse. The first one is the easiest one. It is the point and click method. However, I might suggest you to use the second method, which is more accurate, and it is the XPath method. XPaths are kind of formulas. I've created an entire video about the topic. I let you the XPaths we are going to use in the description as well, but please note that they might change over time. In other words, I invite you to use the XPaths as long as they are valid, and if it's no longer the case, you can still rewrite them or using the point and click method. Let's get started. I've got my starting URL. I come back to Octoparse. I paste my URL and I click on start. The first thing we are going to create is a loop item, meaning I select all the restaurants within the first page. And the point is I don't want to target sponsored results. I only want to target, well, SEO results. I turn off by browse mode, and with the point and click method, I select my first item, I select my second item. I've got 10 items selected and I extract the text. That's one way of doing things. Another way is to modify the XPath here. The XPath for the loop item is that one. I replace the former one by the new one. I go to options and I add a 1 second timeout. I also remove my extract data step because for now, I do not need it. All right, what's next? I have selected 10 items on the first page, but there are more than one page. In other words, I want to select the next page button. Same thing as before with the point and click method. It will be something like this. I click on the next page button. I make sure that the last element I have selected is an A tag, an A element, because an A tag represents a URL. And in order to move from one page to another one, we use a URL. It makes sense. And I loop click on the URL. There we go. I set up a higher AJAX timeout, something like 10 seconds, and my workflow is updated. I click on options, I add another second as a timeout. I click on apply, and same thing for my pagination. 1 second. Same thing as before. I can modify the XPath if needed. How to know if that works? I'm going to check it out. We are on the second page, and if I click on pagination and unclick to paginate, I should be able to reach the third page. If it is the case, it means the pagination is correct. It is correct. Now let's come back to the first page. Now we have to click on each detailed page, and finally, we will extract all the data we need. Pagination, loop item, and the tricky part is to identify what the URL is. I think this is the URL. There we go. It is a URL indeed, because we have selected an A element. With the point and click method, click URL, I go to options. I verify that open in a new tab is checked. It's very important. And I add a 1 second timeout as well. I'm going to change the XPath just in case. The XPath is that one. There we go. I check it out one more time and my XPath is valid. Now it's time to extract data. The store name, the rating, the reviews, the type, the address, the website, and the phone number. I'm also going to extract the URL of the detail page. I add a step. I add an extract data step. I'm going to add a 5 seconds timeout. And to add the URL, I click on Add Custom Field, Page Level Data and Page URL. I'm going to show you how to extract the store name, how to do it with the XPath method as well, and then you redo the same process for all data fields. Point and click method, point and click. Very easy. With the XPath method, it is something like this. I add custom field, capture data on the page, I add my XPath, I add my field name, which is store name, I confirm, and I've got my store name. All right, I'm going to do the same process for all data fields, and I see you back in a minute. I can simply run my task. I click on run and I click on standard mode. Now the only thing which is paramount to do is to wait until your task is completed. I told you we can get up to 240 data hours and we have got 240 data hours. I export my data in an Excel file and here is what it should look like. This is the end of the video. I hope you have enjoyed it. If it's the case, you can give a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. And if you want to script leads in an easier way, you can still take a look at scrap.io. I work with them, so if you have any questions regarding the software, you can ask them in the comments. The link remains in the description. See you next time.